I was getting ready for bed the other day, and I was doing my evening ritual, which was to fill my coffee pot full of water and get the coffee set on automatic so that when I woke up in the morning, I was ready to have my coffee. That's kind of how I start my day. The problem was when I went to fill up the coffee pot, there was already water in the coffee pot. It seemed like I was a little more efficient on that particular morning. Or that particular evening, and I started to fill it, and then of course water went all over the place, and that's what happens when you try to fill something that's already full. But it kind of got me thinking about this idea of full and empty. And you know, as I thought about it more, I thought in general, we kind of think of one as positive and the other as a negative, right? I mean, we think of full as being good. And we think of empty as being bad. I mean, if we're empty, we're hollow. We don't have anything in us. And when we're full, we talk about being filled with the Holy Spirit or filled with joy, right? And so those two words got me thinking, and I realized as I was trying to fill an already full coffee pot that filling it again wasn't going to make it better. It was just going to make a big mess, right? And I thought, you know, I think that's what we do a lot in our lives. We, who are very full people, have very full calendars, have very busy, busy schedules, try to continue to fill what's already full. And we try to do this even with our spiritual life, too. I mean, we try to find ways to fit God into our lives that are already so full that really trying to cram God in is just going to, like everything else, make a mess. And it got me to thinking about some of the images that I saw in Scripture. And there's one particular image. I mean, it comes from the book of Colossians, a letter that Paul wrote to the church in Colossae, and he doesn't really talk about being full and empty, but he talks about being clothed, and he also talks about putting off or taking off some of these things before you put on your clothes or clothe yourself. And so he talks about taking off, you know, things like impurity and passions and evil desires and greed and anger and malice and abusive language. He talks about taking off all of these things so that we can put on other things. Things like, he says, as God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, clothe yourself with compassion, kindness, humility, meekness, and patience, bearing with one another. And if you have a complaint against another, forgive the other. Let go of that. Empty yourself of that anger and frustration. And above all these things, he says, clothe yourself with love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. You know, I was thinking about that, and I thought about how, as important as it is that Paul says that we have to clothe ourselves with these things, if we don't take off the other things, we could just make a big mess. Becoming empty is not always something we think about when it comes to our spiritual life. But if we do not find a way to empty ourselves of our own desires, empty ourselves of what we believe is our needs, empty ourselves from everything that could distract us from the presence of God, we'll never experience, I don't believe, the fullness of God. How do we put on love? How do we put on compassion? How do we put on forgiveness when we are so filled with anger and frustration and just the general anxiety that goes on with life? So, as important as it is that we're full, it's also important that we recognize that empty can be good too. Because when we are empty, then God can fill us. And that mess that we're often making of our lives won't be quite so messy. So, it's odd how sometimes little mistakes we make can become illustrations for us for how to live. But perhaps that is how God works in our lives. So today, yes, be filled with the Holy Spirit, be filled with the joy and the love of God. But perhaps before you do, take note of what you have to empty yourself of first, and then God will do the rest.